We believers have something greater for succeeding. What is it? It is the God factor. God wants us to excel. And since He is an excellent God, He gives us everything needed for you and I to excel in our area of work. Friends, God has called us for excellence. You may say, Pastor, everyone in my workplace is hardly working. They work when the boss is around, but if he is not there, hardly anyone works. We do not work for the boss. We work for God. And God does not work a person who works with complacency or a shabby work. God only blesses excellence. You play music, you be excellent in playing music. You are preaching, give an excellent sermon. You are a believer, be an excellent believer. You're working as a teacher or a computer engineer, you are a housewife or in the medical profession, or maybe you are a student. Whatever you are doing, God wants us to excel, to do the best that you can. And only then God can make us into success in our lives. Ecclesiastes chapter 9 and is verse 10. Whatever your hand finds to do, do it with all your might. You see, God is stressing on giving you 100% in whatever we do. Don't think that your job is not where you are ministering, or house, you are a housewife and no one is looking at your job and you, it's not an important place to be in. Wherever God has placed you, that is your place of ministry. So God is expecting you to do that with all your 100% effort and hard work. Colossians chapter 3, verse 23. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart. Put your heart, soul, and mind into your work as working for the Lord. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 7. Serve wholeheartedly as if you were serving the Lord, not people. So God is watching whatever we are doing. And we are in turn serving God when we are working. Therefore, God is telling, do it with excellence. Do it 100% commitment. Open your Bibles with me now to Genesis chapter 39. In this chapter, we can find the excellence of Joseph. Joseph excelled in whatever he did in his life. Joseph was one of the 12 sons of Jacob, favored by his father, and because of the favoritism, the brothers removed the robe that his father gave and put him into an empty well. There, when the brothers saw that a group of Ishmaelites merchants were traveling to Egypt, who are these people? Sarah, Hagar. Hagar's son is Ishmael. So group of Ishmaelites merchants were traveling to Egypt. They felt that it is better to sell him off. And he was settled for 20 pieces of silver. He's pleading. Joseph is pleading. Please, I want to see my daddy. I want to go back to my house. I want to be with you guys. But they never listened to him. And he was sold for 20 pieces of silver to Egypt. Now here is Joseph. He comes to Egypt. Maybe bound by a chain, because who knows, he will run away. They have paid money for him, right? So he's bound in a chain. Hardly any food to eat. He's taken to the slave market in the heart of Egypt. And here comes people to buy people. And Potiphar comes. Who is Potiphar? The chief commanding officer of the greatest ruler of the ancient world. He comes. He looks at Joseph. He likes him. And he settled maybe double the money they would have paid. If he has bought for 20... And they have brought him this far, maybe probably 40 pieces of silver or 50 pieces of silver. Joseph has been bought by Potiphar. What a sad state for a man who is not only sold once, but he's sold twice. In front of him, they're bargaining his own brothers. In front of him, Potiphar is bargaining for him. how much it would have put him down. And Joseph was taken by Potiphar, and all of a sudden, from the slave market, he finds himself in a wonderful palace, the palatial house of Potiphar. Joseph would have been waiting for food to eat, and when he saw the wonderful varieties of food that was in the table of Potiphar, he would have been so happy. What was taken away from me? He would have just eaten everything and filled his stomach. The Bible says, Genesis chapter 39 verse 4, Joseph found favor in his eyes and he became an attendant. Look at the excellence of Joseph over here. He came as the lowest slave. There were many other slaves in that house, and Joseph came as the lowest slave. Very soon, he became Potiphar's personal attendant, personal assistant. That means Potiphar had so much of trust in Joseph that he could give him the care of his clothes that he wore, the car keys, his money, everything was given. Joseph was taking well care, a personal assistant, the first promotion that came into the life of Joseph. Look at the second promotion. Potiphar put him in charge of his household. Second promotion, not only Potiphar's life, but Joseph, you take care of the entire house. I'm giving you all my house. So you know everything is there for you. You manage it well. I trust you. Second promotion, salary raise. What a joy for Joseph. All of a sudden, sold out of his father's house, he's finding somewhere to put his foot on, somehow establishing in life. Third promotion, and he entrusted to his care everything he owned. His money, his assets, everything that Potiphar owned, not only in that house, every area was given over to Joseph. That was the high level of trust Joseph earned in front of Potiphar. And that was the excellence of Joseph's work. This is how God wants us to excel, friends. When we are working in a corporate, when we are working for somebody, or when we are working for our own selves, God wants us to give our 100% effort into it. God wants us to excel. Joseph did not need any reminders. If Potiphar tells Joseph, today evening, when I come, I want mutton biryani, chicken kebab, and some Manchurian, he will never forget. Potiphar will not have to be calling him in the office and tell, did you remember what I tell you? And when he comes back in the plate, he will find exactly what he wanted, the way he wanted. No reminders. When we work in the corporate, and when we have been given responsibilities, a job, God wants us to excel in doing our work without reminders, so that we can excel in our workplace. We are working for the Lord. And here is the key. You want to be an exemplary child of God in your workplace? Give more than you are paid for. Never ever tell that I will do only so much because they are paying me so much. No. We are supposed to give more than we are paid for. We are supposed to do our jobs without reminders. We are supposed to do our job without error. And that's the excellence that Joseph had. And that's a confidence Potiphar had on Joseph. Soon, Potiphar's wife gets interested in Joseph and pesters him day and night for a physical relationship with her. Joseph refused to go to bed with her or even be with her. But one day, Joseph went to the house to attend to his duties, and Potiphar's wife saw that he was all alone. Now listen to me. Why would Joseph go to the house of Potiphar when his wife was all alone? That was something what Joseph did about his work. He was a manager. He was a smart worker. He would go before everyone could go to see what is it that master needs, which place needs arrangement, what can I do today, how can I manage the people under me to take best care of my master. That's why he went over there. Probably he went after all the people worked also. Is everything right? Many people, if you are in the managerial post, you assign and then you don't go back and see. Only on the final day when the results are being produced, you find what happened because you never followed up. And by the time the product is coming, it is not the way that you wanted. Joseph was not like that. He would go early and then he would stay back late so that whatever he wanted, he would get it in absolute quality. He wanted to please his master in what he did. And in pleasing his master, he was not pleasing Potiphar, he was pleasing the Almighty God. Friends, whatever work you're doing, do it without reminder. Do it with excellence. Do it without mistake and give back more than you are paid. What happened? Joseph, suddenly sensing he is in danger and Potiphar's wife has just caught hold of him, he left his cloak and he ran away. Earlier, one cloak got him in trouble. That was a cloak given by his father. The dress given by his father, that brought him in trouble. And it was removed out of him. And they cut a wild animal and presented it to his father. Now, after a long time, finally one cloak has come back to him. A cloak of a manager. Again, knee down, full sleeved, probably ornamented, because he's a manager of the estate. And all of a sudden, the same cloak is haunting him again. It becomes the evidence that he has attempted rape. Evening, Potiphar came home and soon she produced this evidence and charged Joseph with attempt to rape. And Potiphar, the Bible says, put him to prison. Now, he did not go to an ordinary prison. He went to the toughest prison. Because the prison that Joseph went was a special prison where king's prisoners, the ones who revolted against Pharaoh, were kept awaiting death sentence. It was a tough prison, not an ordinary prison. You know, that was the plan of God in Joseph's life. And Joseph was kept in a special prison where Pharaoh's prisoners were kept. And there he excelled. He said, I'm not going to give up because I didn't do anything wrong. I lost a job, so what? I'm righteous. God is with me. I will get success even in the prison. That was his attitude. Never give up attitude. No matter which job he loses, who is accusing him, he would never bother. It never comes to his head. For him, wherever he is, he wants to excel. Even in the prison, he wants to excel. See in Genesis 39 verse 22 to 23. So the warden put Joseph in charge of all those held in the prison. In the prison, he got the number one first promotion. He came as the least of prisoners. Everyone else was Pharaoh's employee. This man is Potiphar's employee, the latest prisoner, the least among the lot. But soon he excelled. He had a never give up attitude. And he got the number one promotion in the prison. He became in charge of all those held in the prison. Second promotion, listen. And he was made responsible for all that was done there. In charge of the people is one. And all that is done in a prison is different. There's a whole lot of activities that happens in the prison. No one puts anyone to prison and then feeds them 24/7. And gets nothing out of them. You go to prison, there is a lot of activities. They wake up, there is a lot of exercise over there. There is gardening, there is small-scale industry, there is studies that happen to the prisoners. Whole lot of activity. And they get back for what they pay them. And Joseph found so much of favor in the eyes of the prison warden that he put him in charge of all the activities of the prison. Second promotion came for Joseph in prison. The Bible says the warden paid no attention, verse 23, to anything under Joseph's care, because the Lord was with Joseph and gave him success in whatever he did. You see, what we find over here is that no matter where he is in life, what he does in life, he did it with so much of excellence and God gave him success. God was with him. Friends, I don't know what you are up to this morning time. You may be a manager. You may be an employee. Maybe you are in a crossroad, like from the experience of prison to from Potiphar's house, a manager to the prison, or in between jobs. You may be going through a tough secular job, but I want to tell you, you may be in the prison, you may be in Potiphar's house, you may be in the slave market, or you may be in the empty well. If you are with God, you can excel no matter what is the situation around you. Amen? Praise the Lord. So don't give up hope. Sometimes we go through tough times. It's not that Joseph went through all highway in his life. No. He went through the empty well. He went through rejection. He went through being sold. He was in the slave market. He was in his Potiphar's house. He was again accused and he became a prisoner. He had ups and downs and ups and downs in his career. But he never gave up his attitude. He never gave up his perspective in what was going through. He knew that if he is with God and God is with him, no matter what the circumstances, he can excel in life. Hallelujah. So wherever God has placed you, God is there with you. Do your best and you will see the miracle working hand of God in your life. 2 Corinthians chapter 8 verse 7. Look at Paul talking to the Corinthian church about excellence. While speaking to them about excellence in giving, he is pointing out the other areas of excellence in their lives. But just as you excel in everything, believers, you are supposed to be excellent in everything. And when God sees that excellence, that you are giving that extra attention for excellence, he will prosper you because we serve a God of excellence. Come to 2 Corinthians 8, 7. Just as you excel in everything. What is it? In faith, in speech, in knowledge, in complete earnestness, in love. See that you also excel in the grace of giving. That means we are supposed to excel in everything that we do. I remember my life growing up. I always loved to work for the Lord. And I remember whenever I work, I give my 100% for God's work. I did not know any talent when I started serving in the church. So the pastor said, "What can you do?" I said, "Pastor, I don't know anything." The pastor took me to the toilet. Said, you can clean the toilet. That you know? I said, "Yes." And I would clean the toilet. And I would clean it as it is my toilet. And soon I got a promotion. He said, "Why don't you learn the sound system?" That time we had old Ahuja speakers and Ahuja one amplifier. Just 4 knobs to do, nothing much to. You just got to adjust the sound, good hearing, that's it. Nowadays it's become very complicated. I excelled in that. Very soon I became a keyboardist in the church. Very soon, out of no talent, I became the worship leader of the church. Then I became the assistant pastor of the church, became the cell leader of the church. And today, I am a pastor of the church because right from my starting scratch ministry, what I did it with excellence. I would be there on time. I would make sure that no one has anything to complain about anything that I did. And I want to tell you, people whom I worked for never honored me, but my God honored me. Hallelujah. And that's the Lord of Joseph. Friends, excel in everything that you do. Now, how did Joseph excel? So there are 2 ways. It's like 2 wheels of the cycle going together for you to excel. You understand what I'm telling you? 2 wheels of the cycle, and you are the one. One is God aspect of excellence. One is a believer's aspect of excellence. And when both this rotate together, a believer is proceeding to excellence. I'm talking to you from my life. And look at Joseph. The God factor was very much evident. And anyone who is a believer, you have the God factor for excellence. The worldly people say, work hard, study hard, somehow climb the corporate ladder for success. But I want to tell you, we believers have something greater for succeeding. What is it? It is the God factor. God wants us to excel. And since he is an excellent God, he gives us everything needed for you and I to excel in our area of work. You understand what I'm telling you? Look at what the God factor in Joseph's life. God's assurance of excellence. Number one, God is with us. Remember that God is with you to excel you in the areas that you need excellence. Genesis chapter 39 verse 2. The Lord was with Joseph and he prospered. The Lord was with Joseph and he excelled. You see, God factor is a very key factor. God was with Joseph. Is God with every believer? I don't think so. God is near them who draws near to God. Draw near, the word says, draw near to God and he will draw near to you. So when we say no to our wickedness and we draw near to God, we can be assured that God is there in our life. And if God is there in our life, we can definitely excel. And what happens when God is there in our life? When God is in our life, number one, we become automatically successful. When we draw near to God and God is with us, we become instruments of success. Genesis chapter 39 and it's verse 3. His master saw that the Lord was with him and the Lord gave him success. Friends, if God is with you, he will give you success. Genesis 39, 23. The warden paid no attention to anything under Joseph's care because the Lord was with Joseph and gave him success in whatever he did. If God is with us, he will give us success. Secondly, if God is with us, he will give us favor. Not like the worldly people. We have a special favor to excel, for succeeding and prosperity. God gives us favor with people. When you're working with tough people, difficult clients, people who do politics around you, it is God who gives you favor with people. Genesis 39 verse 21. The Lord was with Joseph. He showed him kindness and granted him favor in the eyes of the prison warden. You see, favor comes from where? God gives you favor. Favor with people. Secondly, when you go through a tough time, you must understand that you are having God's favor provided God is with you. Joseph went through a tough time in Potiphar's house. What was it? Accusation. Took the cloak against him. Said, this is the proof that he left behind and he ran. And if you study ancient history and the practice of Egypt, anyone who is a rapist or an attempt to rape case, they were given the death penalty. No sentence, no hearing. Direct death penalty. And what awaited for Joseph because of this case was he was supposed to be hanged to death. But Potiphar, what did he do? He put him to prison. God gave him favor with Potiphar. Now Potiphar's thinking is like this. He knows Joseph very well. He knows his wife very well. And he gave Joseph the benefit of doubt. He doesn't know who is true, who is lying. But he did not give him the death penalty and put him to prison. Favor with people. There will come situations where things are against you in your workplace. There will come situations where you are found guilty, unnecessarily pulled up by your company. But I want to tell you, if God is with you, he will give you favor with people. He will give you favor in your trouble. Can I hear an amen? Amen. Praise the Lord. God's favor. Thirdly, understand, wherever you are placed, God blesses the surroundings because of you. You are teaching in that school is blessed because of you. You're working in a factory, that factory is a blessing because of you. You know it, and very soon God will reveal it to the people around you that you are the source of their blessings. Genesis chapter 39 verse 5. From the time he put him in charge of his household and all that he owned, the Lord blessed the household of Egyptian because of Joseph. You must understand that you and I are the channel of blessing wherever God has placed us. Amen. Praise the Lord. So God's factor is there. He told us that he will give us success. He will give us favor with people, favor in trouble. And he has promised you, wherever you are working, wherever you are placed, that place is blessed just because of his presence in your life. It's up to us to take God's favor, God's success, God's presence, and lead it to excellence in our lives. Amen? Praise the Lord. Shall we close our eyes this morning time? Father, in the name of Jesus, I commit my brothers and sisters who have committed themselves to this word of God. We do not know the situations, Lord, the work, the stress, the targets, Lord, the people that are above them, people that are under them, the studies. We commit everything into the hands of God. And Lord, we pray and we thank you for the assurance right now that you are with us. And you, when you are with us, you will give us prosperity. You will give us excellence, Lord. And I pronounce your blessings upon your people right now, Lord Jesus. Ruba raba shikara da rabasi. I pray for success right now. I pray for the favor of God with people around who is working against them. Right now, I release the favor of God upon your people. Lord, like Potiphar realized that Joseph is a source of blessing, I pray that people around them will realize that the true source of blessing is God and through your child working in that place. I pray that you will give them the grace to overcome the pressures of job. Lord, we pray that they will be able to do more than the worldly people. They will be able to give back more than what we receive from our worldly boss, Lord Master. Bless them. In Jesus' name we pray.